According to VA statistics, since 2002, over 800,000 service members have mobilized, but only 39% of these have used Veterans Affairs health care. Now there are VA employees across the nation whose job it is to reach out to our newest veterans and their families.
In central Pennsylvania, Army veteran Bill Smathers has one short commute to the office. That's it.
This is my office. I spend 4 out of 5 days a week in the car traveling. I put about 50,000 miles a year on the car.
As a transition patient advocate, or TPA, Bill reaches out to veterans in his assigned area.
Well, what does that mean to the veteran? Instead of sitting at a VA medical center waiting for the patients to come in, we actually go out to the veteran.
PTAs like Bill fan out all across the country to tend to the needs of new combat veterans.
Many of the veterans that are coming back from Afghanistan and Iraq, they're not going to the veteran centers, the VAs, to seek medical help. The ones that need to help many times, especially if you're talking about PTSD or TBI, are those the ones that are sitting at home.
An important part of VA's OIF-OEF outreach is to encourage all combat veterans to take advantage and enroll in the free medical services VA has set up for them.
Why not take a little bit extra effort? What I like to tell everybody is when this same veteran got recruited, a recruiter went to his home, he picked him up to take him to the MEP station to test, he came to the house to talk to the parent, and they picked him up when it was time for him to ship to go on active duty. But when he got wounded, when he got blown up, when he got shot, who was at the house? Nobody. You know, I want to change that.
Good to see you again, man.
Come on in.
Looking good, looking good.
Smathers brings that extra effort to Army veteran Doug Mignot.
This guy has 22-inch arms. He's a world-class weightlifter.
I had a 605-pound squat, 425 bench press, 570 deadlift.
If you see someone that physically strong, that he wouldn't have a care in the world, and he does. He fights it every day. In Doug's situation, he's having a very hard time adjusting since he came back from the war. He's a Purple Heart recipient. He was decorated for valor. And he'll be the first to tell you that he's not the same person that came back when he left. He would really like to stay in the military, but because of his medical condition, he's in the process of being boarded out. And that's how I established rapport with him. He wanted to know what to expect.
It helped me understand the system a little bit better, how it works being separated from the military.
Part of the big picture for new veterans is 5 free years of VA health care for any combat injuries or illnesses that they sustained while they were serving. For the world-class weightlifter, Doug says carrying the weight of the world on your shoulders is not healthy.
It's not going to make you less of a man to admit that you have a problem. You're going to be so full of pride and proud of everything you accomplished in Iraq. Now you got to swallow your pride and admit that you have a problem and get the health care and the care that you need.
For Bill, helping veterans is a long road.
And it's more than just going to the veterans' homes. Once you get to the home, that's when the work starts. These guys bring with them a lot of issues, some very complicated. I help them work through the maze of the bureaucracy to, again, either get the health care or the benefits that they're entitled to.
Like Bill, who served 24 years in the Army, the majority of the transition patient advocates are OIF, OEF veterans themselves.